Very good morning to all of you. My name is Shruti Mishra. I am Assistant Professor at Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. My today's topic is Performance Appraisal Method. This is the class for the BCom Honours and BCom LLB 4th semester students. So we'll start with the Performance Appraisal Methods. Firstly, we need to understand that what exactly Performance Appraisal Methods means. Performance appraisal methods means those tools which help the appraiser to appraise the performance of an employee. So there are the certain type of methods which has been using by the organizations to understand the holistic performance of the employee. So first one is essay appraisal. Essay appraisal is basically, first I should tell you what exactly is written, which merely requires the writer to write a series of the statements concerning on the individual's strength, weakness, past performance and potential for the promotions. So essay appraisal means the writer write down the series of the different statements which actually denote the strength, weakness, what exactly he has or she has done in the past performance, what exactly the past performance was like, and is that person is capable for the promotions, potential, is that person is has a potential for the promotions or not. So that is in a form of the essay. And finally, it has been assessed by the rater to what type of strength that person has. If that person is having 5 strength and 2 weaknesses, then there can be like, okay, the person is performing in a good manner. Next one is graphic rating scale, in which the rater assesses an individual on the factors such as the initiative, dependability, cooperativeness, attitude and quality of work. So the graphic rating scale method are based on the certain factors. So the certain factors are need to be assessed. These factors are common for all the employees, and the employees are judged only on these factors. So these factors are initiative. Is the person is able or capable enough to take the initiatives in the organization, in the department? And other one is dependability. Is the person majorly depending for the different things on his subordinates, on his managers, on his bosses, or on his colleagues or not? Is the person is capable enough to cooperate with the department and have a good gelling with the department or not? Another one is attitude and the quantity of work. Is the person is able to complete the huge amount of task in a given period of time, and is that person is having a good attitude or not? These are the certain factors which are discussed in the graphic rating scale. Another one is a checklist method. Checklist method in which the rater does not evaluate the performance but merely record it on a series of the questions concerning the employee's behavior. The rater checks yes or no responses. So basically the checklist method is for the yes and no answers. Is the, like, for example, the question can be like, the employee is good in dealing the tough task or the huge a quantity of task in a limited period of time, yes or no? So answer will be yes or answer will be no. So no. So this is all the checklist method. So here there are the 2 points which has been given. Does the individual performance his or her job and show superior ability to express himself or herself? So management by objective means the performance evaluation, which is basically based on the organizational goals and the objective of the individual. So in this particular method, the employer, or you can say the boss and the employee, sit together and discuss about their performances goals, that what and how they need to achieve the how they need to do or how they need to perform their task, and what they have performed that also has been discussed on the roundtable discussion. So there are certain points which has been discussed, like what are the organizational goals and what are the employees' individual goals. Are both are aligned? And if both are aligned, are they able to complete it? And if both are not aligned, that what exactly they need to do to make it in a one aligned form. So this is management perspective. Another one is 360 degree appraisal method. This kind of method ensure that not only the superior that appraises the subordinate, but also the subordinate also appraises the superiors. Colleagues also appraises the colleagues, and individuals who appraises themselves, and all the appraisals are used to arrive at the final appraisal outcome after calculating the average. Now, this 360 degree performance appraisal means as we have studied geometry, so we know the 360 degree means round the clock, right? So those person who are surrounding you in the organization, all are capable enough to judge you, or all are capable enough to check your performance, all are capable enough to appraise your performance. So 360 degree performance appraisal means one boss can be appraised by its subordinates, by its superiors, by its colleagues, by its juniors, by its different stakeholders in the organization. So and the cumulative decision is, once the data will be collected from all the participants, and then there will be a calculation on the basis of the average. Next one is problem solving method. According to the mayor, the first two method, tell and sell and tell and listen method, place the rater in the position of being a judge and force the individual being evaluated into the defensive position. However, the problem method is to take the reviewer out of the role of the judge and make him or her helper and the friend. So basically, the problem solving method is a two method, tell and sell, and second one is tell and listen. Place the rater in the position of the of being a judge and force the individual being evaluated into the defensive position. So the rater will going to judge the individuals in this particular method, and the problem method is to take the reviewer out of the role of the judge. Now, the reviewer will do? Reviewer will behave like that he is a helper or he is a friend of the employee. So this is the problem solving session. This is the whole performance appraisal methods which I have discussed. And if you have any kind of problem, please do let me know on the JV interaction portal. And till then, take care. I'll come up with a new session and with a new topic. Thank you so much, student. Have a good day.